ಸಂಗತಿಗಳ ಜ್ಞಾನದೀಪ.
ಶ್ರೀ ಗುರು ಬಸವಲಿಂಗಾಯ ನಮಃ. ಶ್ರೀ ಬಸವ ಟಿವಿಯ ಸಮಸ್ತ ವೀಕ್ಷಕರಿಗೆ, ವಿದ್ಯಾರ್ಥಿಗಳಿಗೆ ಜ್ಞಾನದೀಪ ಕಾರ್ಯಕ್ರಮಕ್ಕೆ ಸ್ವಾಗತ. ನಾನು ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ ವೆಂಕಟೇಶ್, ಭೌತಶಾಸ್ತ್ರದ ಪ್ರಾಧ್ಯಾಪಕ. ನಾನು ಈ ದಿನ ನಿಮಗೆ ಭೌತಶಾಸ್ತ್ರ ಹೇಗೆ ಈಸಿ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ ಅನ್ನೋದ್ರ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಹೇಳ್ತೇನೆ. ಬೇಸಿಕಲಿ ಈಗ ಫಿಸಿಕ್ಸ್ ಅಂದರೆ ಎಲ್ಲರೂ ತುಂಬ ಟಫ್ ಅಂತ ಅಂದ್ಕೊಳ್ತಾ ಇರ್ತಾರೆ, ಬಟ್ ಅಷ್ಟೇನು ಟಫ್ ಏನಿಲ್ಲ ಫಿಸಿಕ್ಸು. ಅದರಲ್ಲಿ ಯಾವ ರೀತಿ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ ಯಾವ ರೀತಿ ಮಾರ್ಕ್ ಸ್ಕೋರ್ ಮಾಡಬಹುದು, ನಿಮಗೆ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ರಿವಿಜನ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸಸ್ ಥರ ಇವತ್ತು ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ. ಯಾಕಂದರೆ ಡೀಟೇಲಾಗಿ ಹೋಗೋದು ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಕಷ್ಟನೇ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಈಗ ವೆರಿ ಫಸ್ಟು ನಿಮಗೆ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ವೇಟೇಜ್ ಆಫ್ ಮಾರ್ಕ್ಸ್ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಹೇಳ್ತೀನಿ. ಫಸ್ಟು ದಯವಿಟ್ಟು ಕೇಳಿ. ವೇಟೇಜ್ ಆಫ್ ಮಾರ್ಕ್ಸು ಇಲ್ಲಿ ನೋಡಿ, ಇಲ್ಲಿ ನಿಮಗೆ ಫಿಸಿಕ್ಸಲ್ಲಿ ವಿ ಹವ್ ಗಾಟ್ ದಿಸ್ ಮನಿ ಚಾಪ್ಟರ್ಸ್ ಹಿಯರ್. ಒನ್ ಇಸ್ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಒನ್ ಇಸ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಿಕ್ ಚಾರ್ಜಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಫೀಲ್ಡ್ಸ್. ವೇಟೇಜ್ ಆಫ್ ಮಾರ್ಕ್ಸ್ ಗಿವನ್ ಫಾರ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ 8 ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರೋಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಟಿಕ್ ಪೊಟೆನ್ಷಿಯಲ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಕೆಪಾಸಿಟೆನ್ಸ್ 8 ಮಾರ್ಕ್ಸ್. ಕರೆಂಟ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಿಸಿಟಿ 13 ಮಾರ್ಕ್ಸ್. ಮೂವಿಂಗ್ ಚಾರ್ಜಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಮ್ಯಾಗ್ನೆಟಿಸಮ್ 10 ಮಾರ್ಕ್ಸ್. ಐ ಆಮ್ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಟಾಕಿಂಗ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ದಿ ನಂಬರ್ ಆಫ್ ಮಾರ್ಕ್ಸ್ ಅಲಾಟೆಡ್ ಫಾರ್ ಈಚ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಎವರಿ ಚಾಪ್ಟರ್. ಮ್ಯಾಗ್ನೆಟಿಸಮ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಮ್ಯಾಟರ್ 7, EMI 6, AC 7, ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರೋಮ್ಯಾಗ್ನೆಟಿಕ್ ವೇವ್ಸ್ 3, ರೇ ಆಪ್ಟಿಕ್ಸ್ 9, ವೇವ್ ಆಪ್ಟಿಕ್ಸ್ 9, ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದೆನ್ ಡ್ಯುಯಲ್ ನೇಚರ್ ಆಫ್ ಮ್ಯಾಟರ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ರೇಡಿಯೇಷನ್. ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ 5 ಮಾರ್ಕ್ಸ್. ಆಟಮ್ಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಫಾರ್ 5 ಮಾರ್ಕ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ನ್ಯೂಕ್ಲಿಯಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಫಾರ್ 6 ಮಾರ್ಕ್ಸ್. ಸೆಮಿಕಂಡಕ್ಟರ್ ಫಿಸಿಕ್ಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಸೆಮಿಕಂಡಕ್ಟರ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನಿಕ್ಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಫಾರ್ 9 ಮಾರ್ಕ್ಸ್. ಈಗ ನಾವು ಇದರಲ್ಲಿ ಮೋರ್ ದ್ಯಾನ್ 90 ಮಾರ್ಕ್ಸ್ ಯಾವ ರೀತಿ ತೆಗೆಯೋದು? ಸಮ್ಟೈಮ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಒನ್ ವಾಟ್ ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಡೂ ಇಸ್ ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಡಿಸೈಡ್ ವಿಚ್ ಚಾಪ್ಟರ್ಸ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಸ್ಟಡಿ. ಇನ್ ಎ ವೇ ಐಲ್ ಟೆಲ್ ಆಲ್ ದಿ ಚಾಪ್ಟರ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್, ಎಸ್ಪೆಷಲಿ ಇನ್ ದ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಕಾಂಪಿಟೇಟಿವ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಮ್ಸ್. ಈಚ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಎವರಿ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಬೋರ್ಡ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಮ್ಸ್. ದಿಸ್ ಪ್ರೋಗ್ರಾಮ್ ಈಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ಟು ಹೌ ಟು ಮೇಕ್ ಯು ಟು ಸ್ಕೋರ್ ಗುಡ್ ಮಾರ್ಕ್ಸ್. ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದಟ್ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಟೆಲಿಂಗ್. ಯು ಸೇ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ವಿತ್ ಡ್ಯುಯಲ್ ನೇಚರ್ ಆಫ್ ಮ್ಯಾಟರ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ರೇಡಿಯೇಷನ್ ಯು ವಿಲ್ ಹಾವ್ 5 ಮಾರ್ಕ್ಸ್. ಫಾರ್ ಆಟಮ್ಸ್ 5 ಮಾರ್ಕ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಅಗೇನ್ ಫಾರ್ ನ್ಯೂಕ್ಲಿಯಸ್ 6 ಮಾರ್ಕ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಸೆಮಿಕಂಡಕ್ಟರ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನಿಕ್ಸ್ 9 ಮಾರ್ಕ್ಸ್. ಟೋಟಲ್ ದಿಸ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಫಾರ್ 25 ಮಾರ್ಕ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ನೌ ಆ್ಯಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ಪಾಸಿಂಗ್ ವೈಸ್ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಟೇಕ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಸಪೋಸ್ ಟು ಗೆಟ್ 21 ಔಟ್ ಆಫ್ 70. ಇಫ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಪ್ರಿಪೇರ್ಡ್ ವೆಲ್ ಫಾರ್ ದಿಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಗೆಟ್ 25 ಪ್ಲಸ್ ಇನ್ ಕೇಸ್ ಇಫ್ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಟೇಕಿಂಗ್ ಪ್ರಾಕ್ಟಿಕಲ್ಸ್ ಮಿನಿಮಮ್ ಸಮ್ 28 ಆರ್ ಸಮಥಿಂಗ್ ಇಟ್ ಬಿ ಲೈಕ್ ಆಲ್ರೆಡಿ ಯು ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಗೆಟಿಂಗ್ 53. ಯು ಆರ್ ಆಲ್ರೆಡಿ ಪಾಸ್ಡ್. ಯು ಪ್ಲೀಸ್ ಡೂ ದಟ್. ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಯು ಬಿ ಥರೋ ವಿತ್ ದಿಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಫರ್ದರ್ ವಾಟ್ ಚಾಪ್ಟರ್ಸ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಟು ಇನ್ಕ್ಲೂಡ್ ಐ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಟೆಲ್ಲಿಂಗ್. ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಇನ್ ಕೇಸ್ ಇಫ್ ಆರ್ ಇನ್ಕ್ಲೂಡಿಂಗ್ ಕರೆಂಟ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಿಸಿಟಿ ಇಟ್ ಬಿ ಫಾರ್ 13 ಮಾರ್ಕ್ಸ್. ಕರೆಂಟ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಿಸಿಟಿ ದಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ 53 ಪ್ಲಸ್ 13 ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿಕಮ್ ಆಲ್ರೆಡಿ 66. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಸಿ ಸ್ಟಿಲ್ ಸಮ್ ಚಾಪ್ಟರ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ದರ್ ಕ್ವೈಟ್ ಕಂಪ್ಯಾರಿಟಿವ್ಲಿ ಕ್ವೈಟ್ ಈಸಿಯರ್ ಚಾಪ್ಟರ್ಸ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಮ್ಯಾಗ್ನೆಟಿಸಮ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಮ್ಯಾಟರ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಅಗೇನ್ ಆಲ್ಟರ್ನೇಟಿಂಗ್ ಕರೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರೋಮ್ಯಾಗ್ನೆಟಿಕ್ ವೇವ್ಸ್. ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರೋಮ್ಯಾಗ್ನೆಟಿಕ್ ವೇವ್ಸ್ ಅರ್ಲಿಯರ್ ಇಟ್ ವಾಸ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಫಾರ್ 2 ಮಾರ್ಕ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದಿಸ್ ಟೈಮ್ ದ ಗಿವನ್ ಅ ವೇಟೇಜ್ ಆಫ್ 3 ಮಾರ್ಕ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ಬಿ 7 + 3 = 10. ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್ ವೇ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಗೋ ಹೆಡ್ ಸ್ಕೋರಿಂಗ್ ಇನ್ ಫಿಸಿಕ್ಸ್ ಇಸ್ ನಥಿಂಗ್. ಬಟ್ ಒನ್ಸ್ ಅಗೇನ್ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಟೆಲಿಂಗ್ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಲೈಕ್ ಟು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಎ ಗುಡ್ ಸಬ್ಜೆಕ್ಟ್ ನಾಲೆಡ್ಜ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಯು ಮಸ್ಟ್ ರೀಡ್ ಎವ್ರಿಥಿಂಗ್. ಬಟ್ ಇನ್ ದಿ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಮಿನೇಷನ್ ಫಾರ್ ದ ಪೀಪಲ್ ಹೂ ಆರ್ ಫೀಲಿಂಗ್ ವೆರಿ ಡಿಫಿಕಲ್ಟ್ ಫಾರ್ ದಮ್, ಅವ್ರಿಗೆ ಮಾತ್ರ ಹೇಳ್ತಾ ಇರೋದು, ಈ ರೀತಿ ಮಾಡಿಕೊಂಡ್ರೆ ಈಸಿ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಈಗ ಟುಡೇ ಐ ವಿಲ್ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ವಿತ್ ಸಮ್ ಸಿಂಪ್ಲೆಸ್ಟ್ ಚಾಪ್ಟರ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಡ್ಯುಯಲ್ ನೇಚರ್ ಆಫ್ ಮ್ಯಾಟರ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ರೇಡಿಯೇಷನ್. ವೆರಿ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಒನ್, ಡ್ಯುಯಲ್ ನೇಚರ್ ಆಫ್ ಮ್ಯಾಟರ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ರೇಡಿಯೇಷನ್. ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಎ ರಿವಿಜನ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಐ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಟೆಲ್ಲಿಂಗ್. ಐ ಆಮ್ ಟೆಲಿಂಗ್ ವಿ ಕಾಂಟ್ ಗೋ ಹೆಡ್ ಇನ್ ಡೀಟೇಲ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ವಾಟ್ ಆರ್ ರಿಕ್ವೈರ್ಡ್ ಫಾರ್ ಯುವರ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಮಿನೇಷನ್. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಅಗೇನ್ ಒನ್ ಮೋರ್ ಥಿಂಗ್, ವೆನ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಸೆಲೆಕ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ದಿ ಚಾಪ್ಟರ್ಸ್ ಯು ಮಸ್ಟ್ ಬಿ ಥರೋ ವಿತ್ ಈಚ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಎವರಿ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಇನ್ ಇಟ್. ಯು ಶುಡ್ ನಾಟ್ ಲೀವ್ ಎನಿಥಿಂಗ್ ಇನ್ ಇಟ್, ಇನ್ಕ್ಲೂಡಿಂಗ್ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ಸ್. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಅಗೇನ್ ಯು ಸೇ ಇನ್ ಡ್ಯುಯಲ್ ನೇಚರ್ ಆಫ್ ಮ್ಯಾಟರ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ರೇಡಿಯೇಷನ್, ಆಟಮ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ನ್ಯೂಕ್ಲಿಯಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಸೆಮಿಕಂಡಕ್ಟರ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನಿಕ್ಸ್ ಒನ್ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ ಇಸ್ ಕಂಪಲ್ಸರಿ. ಯೂಶ್ವಲಿ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಗೆಟಿಂಗ್ ಎ ಕ್ವೆಶ್ಚನ್ ಆಲ್ವೇಸ್, ಇನ್ ವಿಚ್ ಚಾಪ್ಟರ್ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಕಮ್. ನೆವರ್ ಬಿಲೀವ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಇನ್ ಅ ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಚಾಪ್ಟರ್ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ ವಿಲ್ ಕಮ್, ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಮೈಟ್ ಬಿ ಇನ್ ದ ಪ್ರೀವಿಯಸ್ ಸಮ್ 3-4 ಇಯರ್ಸ್ ದೆ ಮೈಟ್ ಆ ಗಿವನ್ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಆನ್ ಆಟಮ್ಸ್. ಡೋಂಟ್ ಕಮ್ ಟು ಎ ಕನ್ಕ್ಲೂಷನ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ ವಿಲ್ ಕಮ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಇನ್ ಆಟಮ್ಸ್. ಇಟ್ ಮೈಟ್ ಬಿ ಇನ್ ಡ್ಯುಯಲ್ ನೇಚರ್ ಆಫ್ ಮ್ಯಾಟರ್, ಇಟ್ ಮೇ ಬಿ ಇನ್ ಆಟಮ್ಸ್, ಇಟ್ ಮೇ ಬಿ ಇನ್ ನ್ಯೂಕ್ಲಿಯ. ಹಿಯರ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ದೆರ್ ಇಸ್ ನೋ ಪಾಸಿಬಿಲಿಟಿ. ಹಿಯರ್ ಇನ್ ಸೆಮಿಕಂಡಕ್ಟರ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನಿಕ್ಸ್ ನೋ 5 ಮಾರ್ಕ್ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಇಫ್ ಅಟ್ ಆಲ್ ಇಫ್ ಯು ವಾಂಟ್ ಟು ಮೇಕ್ ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಮೇಕ್ ಇವನ್ 2 ಮಾರ್ಕ್ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಮೇಕ್ ಇಟ್. ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಅ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಥಿಂಗ್. ನಾವು ಯು ಸೇ ಇನ್ ಡ್ಯುಯಲ್ ನೇಚರ್ ಆಫ್ ಮ್ಯಾಟರ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ರೇಡಿಯೇಷನ್. ನಾವ್ ವಿಲ್ ಗೆಟ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ದಿ ಸಬ್ಜೆಕ್ಟ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಐ ವಿಲ್ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ವಿತ್ ದಿಸ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್ ಎಮಿಷನ್. ವೆರಿ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್ ಎಮಿಷನ್. ಸೊ ಡೆಫಿನೇಷನ್ಸ್ ಯು ಮಸ್ಟ್ ಬಿ ವೆರಿ ಕ್ಲಿಯರ್. ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್ ಎಮಿಷನ್? ಇಫ್ ಅಟ್ ಆಲ್ ಇಫ್ ಐ ಆಸ್ಕ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಸೇ ಲೈಕ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಎನಿ ಪ್ರೋಸೆಸ್ ಇನ್ ವಿಚ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಲಿಬರೇಟೆಡ್. say any process in which electrons are liberated is called as electron emission. So once again, define electron emission means you have to tell like any process in which electrons are liberated is called as electron emission. And now here, next is types of electron emission. Types of electron emission. You have got some four types here. One is, very first one is thermionic emission. Thermionic emission. We can ask any one of these or mention any two types of electron emission. One is thermionic emission. What do you mean by thermionic emission means? Make it very simple. It is a process in which electrons are liberated under the influence of heat. Nothing more than that is required. It is a process in which electrons are liberated under the influence of heat. And the liberated electrons are called usually thermal electrons. And the current constituted is called as thermionic current also. The surface which is giving out electrons is called as thermoemissive surface. You see, one more thing, any process, whether it is thermionic emission or photoelectric emission, one is called photoelectric emission, we'll be seeing this photoelectric emission in detail. And third one is field emission. Third one is field emission, and fourth is called a secondary emission. Sir, one thing what you are supposed to remember is, in any type of emission here, in any type of emission, we need, evacuated glass tube consisting of two electrodes, namely cathode and anode. Always cathode is connected to negative of an external battery, and anode is connected to positive of external battery through a microammeter. For any process, this is an important one. In thermionic emission, what we do, we are heating this by using some filaments, we'll be heating it. And so this cathode emits electrons. When cathode emits electrons, and that electrons are attracted by anode, only when anode is kept at certain potential, positive potential, electrons will be attracted. Otherwise, electrons will be just scattered, electrons will be liberated, and they will be scattered in all possible directions, and some electrons may not move also. Just because we are maintaining potential here, and electrons will be moving towards anode and constitutes current. This is thermionic emission. But once again, I am telling, what is thermionic emission? Just it is a process in which electrons are liberated under the influence of heat. That will be enough for us. And what is photoelectric emission next? Photoelectric emission. This is also a very simple one. It is a process in which electrons are liberated under the influence of light. We'll get into this. More details will be given later. Now another one, field emission. What is field emission means? Here, it is a process in which electrons are liberated under the influence of electric or magnetic field. Under the influence of electric and magnetic fields. See here, in this case, we'll have one cathode, one anode. We'll have one anode. And again, cathode is connected to, and anode is connected to some potential difference. You have to apply a very high potential difference. When you apply a very high potential difference, the potential of the anode itself is able to attract the electrons from the cathode. And electrons are liberated from the cathode and they will move towards anode by constituting current. And so this process is called as field emission. Even you say field emission, sometimes we will be putting this type of questions. Why field emission is also called cold cathode emission? See here, in thermionic emission, as I told, cathode is heated. When cathode is heated, temperature of the cathode increases. And in photoelectric emission, we are allowing light to fall through. Light will be, continuously light will be made to incident on the cathode. When light is incident on cathode, obviously temperature of cathode should increase. When cathode temperature is increased, cathode temperature will be increased, so we call it as, it cannot be called as cold cathode emission. But whereas here, we are not heating or we are not supplying light to this, and electrons are liberated just under the influence of that high potential difference, so it is called as cold cathode emission. Now one more, I was talking about secondary emission. Secondary emission. So what is secondary emission? Here, in any of the earlier methods like thermionic emission or photoelectric emission, field emission, electrons are emitted. Electrons are moving with certain speed, and these electrons, let me say, electrons are made to collide with electrons present in some atoms here. Electrons present in some atoms. those electrons present in the atoms will also be liberated, and that process is called as secondary emission. In a way, what do we say? It is a process in which electrons are liberated due to the bombardment of this word, due to the bombardment of fast moving electrons or any other high energy particles. That is called as secondary emission. Here the electrons which are liberated by one primary emission, they are called as primary electrons, and these electrons will collide with the electrons present in the gases. Those electrons will be liberated. Those electrons are called secondary electrons. So this is about types of electron emission. See, thermionic emission, it is a process in which electrons are liberated under the influence of heat. Photoelectric emission is, it is a process in which electrons are liberated under the influence of light. Field emission, it is a process in which electrons are liberated under the influence of electric or magnetic field. And secondary emission, it is a process in which electrons are liberated due to the bombardment of fast moving electrons or any other high energy particles. Now we will go ahead with the photoelectric effect, most important one. You see, in this very first 5-mark question, what you can expect is, what is photoelectric effect? Describe an experiment to demonstrate photoelectric effect. What is photoelectric effect? And describe an experiment to demonstrate photoelectric effect. You have to write again, what do you mean by photoelectric effect meant? As I told earlier, now we will change a little. The phenomenon in which electrons are liberated under the influence of light is called as photoelectric effect. And the electrons liberated are called photoelectrons. Electrons liberated are called photoelectrons. And the current constituted is called as photoelectric current. Current constituted is called as photoelectric current. And the surface which is giving out electrons, it is called as photoemissive surface. You see the definitions. Usually people will feel difficulty in giving the definitions. ನೀವೇನೋ ಅದ್ರ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ತಲೆ ಕೆಡಿಸ್ಕೊಳ್ಳೋ ಸಿಟಿನೇ ಇಲ್ಲ. ಈಗ ನೋಡಿ, ಫೋಟೋ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಿಕ್ ಕರೆಂಟ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ದ ಕರೆಂಟ್ ಕನ್ಸ್ಟಿಟ್ಯೂಟೆಡ್ ಡ್ಯೂರಿಂಗ್ ಫೋಟೋ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಿಕ್ ಎಫೆಕ್ಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಫೋಟೋ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಿಕ್ ಕರೆಂಟ್. ಡಿಫೈನ್ ಫೋಟೋ ಎಮಿಸಿವ್ ಸರ್ಫೇಸ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ದ ಸರ್ಫೇಸ್ ವಿಚ್ ಎಮಿಟ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಲಿಬರೇಟ್ಸ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ ಡ್ಯೂರಿಂಗ್ ಫೋಟೋ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಿಕ್ ಎಮಿಷನ್ ಈಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಫೋಟೋ ಎಮಿಸಿವ್ ಸರ್ಫೇಸ್. ವಾಟ್ ಆರ್ ಫೋಟೋ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ದ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ ಲಿಬರೇಟೆಡ್ ಡ್ಯೂರಿಂಗ್ ಫೋಟೋ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಿಕ್ ಎಫೆಕ್ಟ್. ದಟ್ಸ್ ಇಟ್. ಸೊ ನೌ ಐ ಟೋಲ್ಡ್ ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಫೋಟೋ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಿಕ್ ಎಫೆಕ್ಟ್. Describe an experiment to demonstrate photoelectric effect. So how easy this means, you need not worry much. See, first you write one diagram. See, diagram is also just a simple diagram only. It will have an evacuated glass tube provided with a quartz window. It is an evacuated glass tube provided with a quartz window. This quartz window is not a necessary condition. It contains two electrodes, namely cathode and anode, and cathode is connected to negative of the battery and anode is connected to positive of the battery through a micro ammeter. And so this is the figure. Just see here, after writing this little, if you want you can label it. It is like, it is an evacuated glass tube. What exactly you are supposed to write, I am telling. Evacuated glass tube, and this is a quartz window, cathode, anode, and again light rays, light of certain frequency is made to incident on cathode. It liberates electrons, and the liberated electrons move towards anode like this. Say this is the anode and this is the cathode. Say once again, after writing the figure, you have to just explain. How to explain this means, arrangement consists of an evacuated glass tube provided with a quartz window. It contains two electrodes, namely cathode and anode. Cathode is connected to negative of the battery. Anode is connected to positive of the battery through a micro ammeter. Tumba simple agi explain madabodu arrangement. Amale what you are doing, that you have to explain. Now you see, according to scheme, if you are giving what is photoelectric effect, describe an experiment to demonstrate photoelectric effect. What is photoelectric effect? 1 mark. For the figure, 1 mark. Explanation of the figure, what did I say? Same thing, whatever is there, I am telling. What is that means? Again, once again, it consists of, arrangement consists of an evacuated glass tube provided with a quartz window. it contains two electrodes, namely cathode and anode. Cathode is connected to negative, anode is connected to positive through a microammeter. Okay. For that one mark. And next, when light of certain, in the next paragraph you can make, when light of certain frequency is made to incident on cathode, it liberates electrons and the liberated electrons move towards anode and thereby constituting photoelectric current, which can be recorded by microammeter. That's it, nothing more than that for these two marks. See, once again, when light of certain frequency, I'll explain why certain frequency. When light of certain frequency is made to incident on cathode, it liberates electrons and the liberated electrons move towards anode and thereby constituting photoelectric current, which can be recorded by microammeter. Okay. Now here we talk about experimental facts about photoelectric effect. This has been observed by Henrik Hertz initially, and then Halvach and Lennard, these scientists, they observed many facts about it. And overall, I'll be summing Halvach and as well as Lennard. These people have observed some facts about this. Experiment has been done by Henrik Hertz initially. So now, here experimental facts about photoelectric effect. In a way, I can say, next important 5-mark question in this is experimental facts about photoelectric effect. One by one, you have to concentrate properly. And if you concentrate properly, it is nothing. Very first thing, this has been even observed by Halvach and Lennard. Photoelectric effect is instantaneous. Photoelectric effect is instantaneous. What is the meaning of instantaneous means? Current is, I mean light is falling on the cathode. Already microammeter is recording current. Time gap of 10 power minus 10 seconds. Around 10 power minus 10 seconds. Nodi, 10 power minus 10 seconds andre, you can't imagine only. 1 second is what? Normally, by the time you close your eye and open, it is 1 second. 1 tenth of a second, in case if I am vibrating this, 10 times in a second, time taken for one vibration is 0.1 second. If I vibrate this 100 times, time taken for one vibration will be 0.01 second. Where can we imagine? In 1 second, 1000 part, where can we imagine? In that way, if I say 10 power minus 10 seconds, where to imagine? So, almost it is instantaneous. But remember, don't write spontaneous. Radioactivity phenomenon is called spontaneous. But always remember, photoelectric effect is instantaneous. And if you want, you can write, there is a time lag of 10 power minus 10 seconds. If not, you need not write. And the very next one, there is a certain minimum frequency. There is a certain minimum frequency above which only photoelectric effect takes place. That frequency is called threshold frequency. Remember this. This point is quite important. There is a certain minimum frequency above which only photoelectric effect takes place. That frequency is called threshold frequency. Here, before talking about that, I'd like to tell you about work function. Say, what is work function means? We know very well, in all metals, you have got many number of free electrons. But those free electrons, these are all, free electrons are bounded to the metal only. You cannot liberate them just easily. They are still bound to the metal. So now, this work function means, some amount of energy if you supply, you can free them. That minimum amount of energy required to remove the electrons or just liberate electrons, we use this term, minimum energy required to just liberate electrons is called as work function. It is denoted by W also, H nu naught we write, and even W equals Hc by lambda naught we write, or even we use phi equals H nu naught. Terminology, you can, denotions, you can do it in any way. That is phi equals h nu naught, and here nu naught is called threshold frequency. Once again, let us get back. There is a certain minimum frequency above which only photoelectric effect takes place. That frequency is called as threshold frequency. That is the second point. Now here, next, when intensity of incident radiation is increased, when intensity of incident radiation, intensity of incident radiation ಇಂಟೆನ್ಸಿಟಿ ಆಫ್ ಇನ್ಸಿಡೆಂಟ್ ರೇಡಿಯೇಷನ್ ಈಸ್ ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸ್ಡ್ ರೇಡಿಯೇಷನ್ ಈಸ್ ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸ್ಡ್ ನಂಬರ್ ಆಫ್ ಫೋಟೋ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ ಲಿಬರೇಟೆಡ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸಸ್ ಪ್ರೊವೈಡೆಡ್ ದ ಫ್ರೀಕ್ವೆನ್ಸಿ ಆಫ್ ಇನ್ಸಿಡೆಂಟ್ ರೇಡಿಯೇಷನ್ ಶುಡ್ ಬಿ ಅಬೋವ್ ದಿ ಥ್ರೆಶೋಲ್ಡ್ ಫ್ರೀಕ್ವೆನ್ಸಿ ಕಮನ್ ಅಬ್ಸರ್ವ್ ದಿಸ್ ಒನ್ಸ್ ಅಗೇನ್ ವೆನ್ ಇಂಟೆನ್ಸಿಟಿ ಆಫ್ ಇನ್ಸಿಡೆಂಟ್ ರೇಡಿಯೇಷನ್ ಈಸ್ ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸ್ಡ್ ನಂಬರ್ ಆಫ್ ಫೋಟೋ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ ಲಿಬರೇಟೆಡ್ ಡೆಫಿನೆಟ್ಲಿ ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸಸ್ ಪ್ರೊವೈಡೆಡ್ The frequency of incident radiation is above the threshold frequency. What is the meaning of this means? Let me say for one metal, work function is some 2 electron volts. Or even I'll say that threshold frequency is some value, some x hertz. Threshold frequency is x hertz. Or even you can take some 4 into 10 power 14 hertz. Just for example, I'm telling 4 into 10 power 14 hertz. And if the frequency, incident frequency is 3.99 into 10 power 14 hertz, no photoelectric effect takes place. It must be 4 and above 4 only. Whatever might be the intensity, you say now, intensity of 1 watt per meter square, I am making it to incident on the cathode. Required frequency is 4. I am using 3 into 10 power 14 hertz, no photoelectric effect. Even make it as 100 watts, no photoelectric effect. Only it must be above threshold frequency, that point. Say here that is, when intensity of incident radiation is increased, number of photoelectrons liberated increases provided. Frequency of incident radiation should be above the threshold frequency. Here, one graphical representation also you are supposed to write. Photoelectric current versus intensity, photoelectric current versus intensity, you can write like this. Intensity is 0, photoelectric current is 0. As intensity increases, photoelectric current also increases. And one more point, fourth point. When frequency of incident radiation is increased, number of photoelectrons liberated remains constant. But whereas kinetic energy of the liberated photoelectrons increases. When frequency of incident radiation is increased, number of photoelectrons liberated remains constant. But whereas kinetic energy of the liberated photoelectrons increases. It is like we need some 2 electron volts, this is the work function to just liberate the electron. I am using same intensity, some 1 watt per meter square intensity I am using, photoelectrons will be liberated. Now I will make use of 3 electron volts. That is frequency has been increased. Say here W equals, I am telling H nu naught. When this frequency is increased, energy will be increased. When energy is increased, number of photoelectrons liberated will be same. That depends on intensity. But because energy has been increased, they will be liberated and as well they will move with certain kinetic energy. So that is, when frequency is increased, number of photoelectrons liberated remains constant, but the kinetic energy of the liberated photoelectrons increases. See here again, photoelectric current versus frequency, if I write photoelectric current versus frequency, if I plot a graph, it will start somewhere here. Reason for that is, less than this, until this, I can take like from here to here, I can take it as nu naught. Less than that, no photoelectrons will be emitted, and more than that only photoelectrons will be emitted. So now here, if I take one extrapolate the graph, whatever you get here, this will be the work function. Okay. Now the last point here, especially for experimental facts about photoelectric effect. Last point is, you know, in this case of cathode and anode, I told in a photoelectric tube here, in the photoelectric effect I was explaining. This is a negative and this is the positive. This is microammeter. And so this is anode is connected to positive. Now why we are maintaining positive potential? I told already, electrons are liberated. There is no rule like electrons should reach anode. And electrons are liberated with different energies. They are liberated and they'll be get scattered. But whereas when you maintain some positive potential here, electrons will be attracted. And keep on increasing the positive potential. Number of electrons reaching the plate increases. Come on, remember here, number of electrons liberated is different. number of electrons reaching the plate is different. Number of electrons reaching the plate may not be equal to number of electrons liberated. But for a certain potential, let me say around some plus 10 volts or something, all the electrons liberated are reaching the anode. Then the current constituted is called saturation current. That will be total current. Now, what I am telling, let me say just as an example, plus 10 volts, total current is saturation current. I will decrease it to plus 5. When I decrease it to plus 5, I told electrons might scatter in all possible directions like this. The electrons which are scattered in this way, they may not be able to reach. And now, I will decrease it to plus 3. Electrons which are moving like this may not be able to reach. That means less electrons are reaching, current constituted is less. In the same way, let me say plus 1 volt, very few electrons will reach the anode. But let me make it as 0. Usually whenever I put this question, when anode potential is made 0, what is the photoelectric current means? Students, vidyarthigalu yen heltare andre, current, photoelectric current is 0. Adre adu athara alla. Illi photo anode potential 0 maintain madidru saha, some of the electrons are reaching. As I told, there is no rule like electrons should reach the anode. There is no rule like few electrons should not reach the anode. So, some electrons are reaching the anode. Okay. Very few electrons will be reaching. Make it as minus 1 volt. Come on, you only observe. When I make minus 1 volt, electrons are negatively charged. Minus 1 is negative. There must be a repulsion. Electrons should not reach. But still, I am telling some electrons with more kinetic energy will reach. Some electrons with more kinetic energy will reach. That is, as because these electrons are all liberated electrons, I am telling they have got a range from 0 to certain maximum kinetic energy. Now make it as minus 2 volts. Very, very few electrons will reach the anode. Very small current will be recorded. Now let me say, I am making it as minus 3 volts. No electrons will reach. Photoelectric current ceases. And this potential is called stopping potential. Now you see, what I am telling here is, when anode potential, last point, when anode potential is decreased, number of photoelectrons reaching the plate decreases. But for a certain negative potential, the number of photoelectrons reaching the plate becomes zero and photoelectric current ceases. That potential is called a stopping potential. That stopping potential depends on frequency of incident radiation. Sometimes I'll be giving one example. It is like some students might ask, when it is minus 1, how come electrons will be attracted? It is not like attraction. Electrons have got more kinetic energy. When they have got more kinetic energy, they'll negotiate this barrier, this potential, and they'll reach the anode. And even minus 2 also I'm telling, but still sometimes students will not be convinced. I'll be giving one example. If I throw a piece of chalk at any one of you, when it comes near to you and you will put your hand like this and you are applying some force and you are stopping that piece of chalk. That means what? Piece of chalk is coming like this, you are applying force. When you apply force, it has to stop. But whereas, now let me say, just one bullet, I'll take a revolver and I'll fire at you. Can you put your hand like this? No way, because it will penetrate through your hand. It is in the same way here. No doubt you are opposing it, but still kinetic energy of the electron is more, it reaches. When it is stopped completely, that potential is called as stopping potential. To summarize this, once I'll summarize all these experimental facts, once again, you just concentrate properly and listen. Photoelectric effect is instantaneous. Second point is, there is a certain minimum frequency above which only photoelectric effect takes place. That frequency is called threshold frequency. And next, when intensity of incident radiation is increased, number of photoelectrons liberated also increases, provided the frequency of incident radiation should be above threshold frequency. When frequency of incident radiation is increased, number of photoelectrons liberated remains constant, but the kinetic energy of the photoelectrons increases. And final point, when anode potential is decreased, number of electrons reaching the plate decreases, but for a certain negative potential, the number of electrons reaching the plate becomes zero and then photoelectric current ceases. See, this is called stopping potential. And illige experimental facts about photoelectric effect mugito. Hage, What is photoelectric effect? And describe and explain to demonstrate photoelectric effect. Only two concepts I have explained, and still further we have many things like Einstein's explanation of photoelectric effect. What do you mean by dual nature of matter? What is really, what is exactly dual nature of matter? And all these things we'll be seeing in the next episode. ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಎಪಿಸೋಡಲ್ಲಿ ಕಂಟಿನ್ಯೂ ಮಾಡೋಣ. ಅಲ್ಲಿವರೆಗೂ ಶರಣು, ಶರಣಾರ್ಥಿ.
ಶ್ರೀ ಗುರು ಸ್ಟಡಿ ಸೆಂಟರ್, ಸಿಡೇದಹಳ್ಳಿ, ಬೆಂಗಳೂರು. ದೂರವಾಣಿ ಸಂಖ್ಯೆ 9845477404. ವಿದ್ಯಾರ್ಥಿಗಳ ಜ್ಞಾನದೀಪ.
ಓಂ ಶ್ರೀ ಗುರು ಬಸವ.